Number one, loan waiver for the farmers. Number two, remunerative price as 1.5 times the cost of production as recommended by the National Commission on Farmers, headed by the great agricultural scientist whose name all of you know, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. That was the second demand. Third demand, land rights for farmers. Fourth demand, pension for agricultural workers, poor and middle farmers. Increased pension at least 5,000 rupees per month. Fifth demand was a revamping of the public distribution system. So these were five. Other small demands were there, but basically these five demands were there. Why these five demands? Actually, let me tell you, these five demands were not only the demands of Maharashtra. They are the demands of the farmers all over India. They are the demands of the agricultural workers, including Manrega, etc., all over India. And therefore, the Long March had such a tremendous reception all over the country, precisely because the demands of the Maharashtra Long March were the demands of the farmers all over the country, not just in Maharashtra. Let us come to these demands. Number one, loan waiver. Why do we ask for loan waiver? Because farmers are tremendously in debt. A recent survey has shown more than 85% farmers are continuously in debt, and this debt has increased over the last 20 years. Loan waiver, up to now nobody was talking about it. Mr. Narendra Modi had promised, but in the last 4 years, no loan waiver is given to farmers by the central government. Not one naya paisa. But loan waivers are practically being given to Mr. Lalit Modi, to Mr. Nirav Modi, to Mr. Mehul Choksi, and to Mr. Vijay Mallayya. I think you know all these names. You have heard of all these names. How are they given loan waiver? Very simple method. They take loans from banks, don't pay it back, and when a warrant is issued against them, or is going to be issued against them, they just sit in a plane and go off to London or New York, go away from the country. And a prime minister who takes a lot of pride on his 56-inch chest does not have the guts to get these poor people back in our country. That is the situation that we are facing today. Mr. Nirav Modi goes out of the country, and within a few days, he comes to Davos, Switzerland, where the World Economic Forum summit is being held, and he is photographed with the Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi. After he has gone away from the country, he again comes to Switzerland, gets Nirav Modi, gets photographed with Narendra Modi, and then again goes back. Have we seen anything so shocking? So therefore, not only that, today a handful of corporates, Mukesh Ambani, Anil Ambani, Gautam Adani, and all those close to Narendra Modi have taken loans worth 11 lakh crores of rupees from the Indian banks. I'm sure some of you may be working as bank employees, etc., and you know this. 11 lakh crores of rupees taken from banks, not yet returned. Today with interest, it comes to 12 lakh crore rupees. It is called a euphemism, non-performing assets. NPA. What is the meaning of NPA? Loan taken from banks but not repaid. Out of this, you will be shocked, 3 lakh crore rupees has been actually written off in the last 2 years by the Narendra Modi government. Actually written off. For a handful of corporates, you write off 3 lakh crores, remaining 11 lakh crores you don't insist on it giving back. But when it comes to farmers, crores of farmers all over the country, Mr. Narendra Modi, Mr. Arun Jaitley, Mr. Amit Shah, they are the first to say, we cannot give loan waiver to farmers. This is the situation in the country today, which we have to understand. Friends, why do farmers go into debt? Do they like to go into debt? Do they spend on things that they can't afford? What is the reason? There are 4 reasons. 4 very valid reasons. Number 1, tremendous cost in the agricultural inputs like seeds, fertilizers, insecticide, diesel, water, all these things are growing in the neoliberal phase. Why are they growing? 2 reasons. Number 1, government has cut down on subsidies to farmers. Totally cut down on subsidy. And second, they are giving tremendous encouragement to the multinational corporations, to the Indian corporates in agriculture. Last year, Narendra Modi government has made agriculture 100% open for FDI, foreign direct investment. All these big multinational companies, already they have got tremendous share in the seed production market, fertilizer production market, insecticide production market. Corporates of India have also got in. Why will they produce all these things? Will they do it for charitable purposes? No, friends. Marx said 150 years ago in the Communist Manifesto, in the book Capital, he said, capitalism exists only to make profits. 150 years later, what Karl Marx said has become even more true. All these multinational and Indian corporates are now producing fertilizers, seed and insecticide, tremendous profit, and the farmer is being looted. These are the reasons. First reason why the cost of inputs has tremendously grown. Apart from loan waiver, the second very important demand was remunerative price for the crop. Actually, no central government in independent India has ever implemented that demand. Never. Dr. Swaminathan had very correctly pointed out, if the agrarian crisis is to be stopped, if farmer suicides are to be stopped, one, you have to reduce the cost of inputs. Second, you have to give remunerative price which will cover complete cost of production of the farmer plus 50% profit. Very simple formula. Complete cost of production plus 50% profit. If that happens, the farmer will come out of problems. Simple as that. But this has never been done. The Modi government, in 2014, during the Lok Sabha elections, 440 meetings they took, and the Prime Minister in waiting, he assured in every meeting, if I come to power, I will implement Swaminathan Commission recommendation, cost of production plus 50%. What did he do? Within 9 months, 20th of February 2015, he gives an affidavit to the Supreme Court of India. What does he say? He says, we cannot implement this demand. Although we have promised you, we cannot implement this cost of production plus 50% because it will distort the market. And now he is saying we have done it. MSP, he is saying that we have already implemented. Swaminathan Commission, you are seeing on TV, you are seeing in the papers, all that. But what has he done? More white lie cannot be there in the country. And I am sorry to say that the Prime Minister is a very great expert in telling untruths. I am not using the word lie because it's an unparliamentary word. Yesterday only we heard the no confidence debate. But total untruth. What Mr. Amit Shah calls chunav ka jumla, that also you must have heard in Hindi. But you see, I will give you one example. Latest MSP he has declared, 3rd of July, this month. What has he declared for paddy? Tamil Nadu, you have a lot of paddy production. I am only giving one example. He has declared 1750 rupees per quintal for paddy. New MSP this year. If you see the Swaminathan Commission, there is a formula called C2 plus 50. How much does it come? How much should the farmer get? They have calculated he should get 2340 rupees per quintal according to the Swaminathan Commission. How much has the Modi government declared? 1750. How much less? 590 rupees less per quintal only for paddy. For every crop there is difference. For dal it is tremendous. From 1800 rupees to 2300 rupees less than the Swaminathan Commission they have declared. How will the farmer survive? How will he survive? And therefore, we have a situation where we are demanding this. It is precisely because every government has looted farmers in the last 70 years, especially in the last 4 years, that we are demanding loan waiver, not as a beggarly thing. We are demanding as our right. We are demanding loan waiver as a compensation for the loot your policies have done to the farmers for all these years. And therefore, that is the reason cause for loan waiver that all of us must understand. Land question, land rights. Today what has happened? I told you land to the tiller was the slogan. What is Narendra Modi government slogan? New slogan. They don't say it aloud, but the slogan is land to the corporates. That is the new slogan of the BJP government. You see all their things. You see your Salem Chennai green corridor, so called big struggle is going on that thing. We are having the Mumbai Ahmedabad bullet train. You have hundreds of accidents last this thing, and he wants a bullet train which will cost 5000 rupees. A Mumbai Ahmedabad flight ticket is 2000 rupees. Can you imagine? In 1.25 hours you go to Ahmedabad with a 2000 rupee ticket. You are going to take 6 hours or maybe 4 hours Mumbai to Ahmedabad, and the ticket they are saying 3000, but by the time everything happens it will be more than 5000. For every project land is going to be taken. Land is going to be forcibly taken from farmers. They have a huge scheme. You all should know about it. Delhi-Mumbai Industrial Corridor, Amritsar-Calcutta Industrial Corridor, Vishakhapatnam-Chennai Industrial Corridor, Chennai, Bangalore industrial corridor, and then again Bangalore, Mumbai industrial corridor. Five industrial corridors. Lakhs of farmers' land is going to be forcibly taken to be given to whom? To all these corporates. Gautam Adani, Mukesh Ambani, Anil Ambani, and all jingbang lot. All of them, they are going to get land at the expense of whom? At the expense of farmers. That is why land rights. That is what we are fighting for. Tribals in this country. In Tamil Nadu also Adivasis are there. 2006 Forest Rights Act was enacted by Parliament after years and years. No Congress government enacted. No BJP government enacted. It was because of the struggles of the tribals, led by the All India Kisan Sabha, led by many other organizations. And most important, because there were 61 left members of parliament in the Lok Sabha. That is because of this that two major laws were passed. One, the Manarega law, Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, and the second was Forest Rights Act for the tribals, which vests the ownership of land, forest land, in the names of the tribals. These were the two laws that were passed as a result of 61 left members of parliament. That is what happens. The Right to Information Act, about which much is being said, that was also being passed. Mr. Anna Hazare made lot of fuss, but nothing happened. 61 left members of parliament could see that the Right to Information Act was passed by parliament as a result of the pressure of 61 left members of parliament, and also because the Congress did not have a majority on its own. Most fortunate thing. If it had a majority, 61 left MPs could not have done anything. But it did not have a majority. It was depending on the left. And that is where the left said, if you don't pass these laws, then it is a question of you and us. We can withdraw your support at any point of time. This Forest Rights Act has not been implemented anywhere except in Tripura and Kerala, where left governments are there. So that was one of the demands of the Long March. And then I'm not coming into the pension, health, ration, insurance, all these points I'm not going into. I'm coming directly into what you are most interested, the Long March itself. My friends and comrades, we took the decision of the Long March on 16th February this year. We started the Long March on the 6th of March. How many days we got? 17 days for preparation. Many people ask, how did you make such a big preparation in 17 days? That is because for the previous 3 years, we had been continuously fighting. For 3 years, in March 2016, 1 lakh farmers were mobilized by the All India Kisan Sabha in a 2-day sit-in satyagraha in Nasik. 2 days, 2 nights, 1 lakh farmers gathered in Nasik, blocked the main chowk square. All traffic was jammed very peacefully, no violence, totally democratic. For 1 lakh farmers sat there. The second day, the Chief Minister had to call us from Nasik to Mumbai and concede some demands. We came back and then we lifted this satyagraha in the night. So 2 days and 2 nights, 1 lakh farmers, 25 districts of Maharashtra came in one place and had a siege, which is called a sit-in satyagraha. Second, October 2016, 50,000 farmers, Adivasi farmers, this first March, all farmers, Adivasi, non-Adivasi, everybody, all over Maharashtra. Second, October 2016, 50,000 Adivasi farmers gather in Wada, Palghar district, another district, and we gear out the house of the Adivasi Development Minister of the BJP who stays there. 50,000 people, can you imagine? Small house, whatever, big or small, and we closed all roads to that house. Entire Wada is a tehsil place. Entire place was jammed. All the highways going to Mumbai, going to Thane, going to Nasik, going to Surat, every highway was jammed. Again, 2 days and two nights. The minister was so scared. We had given him a memorandum. And he said, no, no, I will come. I will give your demands. But he became so scared, one day before the gherao, he left and ran away. But even then we decided that we have to sit here, whatever happens. We sat there, they sent the Adivasi Development Commissioner at 4 o'clock in the night. 4 o'clock in the night. We said, yes, we are awake. We are always awake. Red flag is always awake. Red flag never goes to sleep. And we said, all right, we'll have discussion. On all tribal demands, for 4 or 5 hours, we had discussion. Night, 3 o'clock to morning. But then we said, we are not satisfied. Until the minister gives us an appointment, we are not going to lift the gherao. Poor fellow, he had to send the fax, give an immediate appointment within 3 days in the state secretariat building. All of us went there. Only then we lifted the gherao. There, entire minister, all the officials, Kisan Sabha people, we had taken SFI, DYFI, ADWA, they had also we had taken along, and all of us had discussions. They agreed and they took out a government order on what they had decided. That was a very major thing that we achieved. This was second. Third, 1st June 2017, 1 year ago, all farmer organizations came together and had what is known historically as a farmer's strike in Maharashtra. All of you must have read about it in the papers. What was a farmer's strike? The farmers refused to get their milk to the cities. They refused to get their vegetables to the cities. They refused to get their fruits to the cities. 11 days the strike went on. Very peaceful. All these actions, the first two actions, independent All India Kisan Sabha, the sit-in Satyagraha and the gherao, independent, only our organization. Third action, June, farmer strike, joined by all the farmer organizations. We brought them together. 11 days there was a strike. The government, BJP government, which said, we will talk only to the real farmers, not to the leaders. On the 11th day, they came down, had a complete discussion with the entire coordination committee. For the first time in the history of Maharashtra, they had to agree to a loan waiver of 34,000 crore rupees. First time they had to agree. There were problems in implementation. That was later it came. But now they had to do at least part of it. I am happy to tell you that nearly 16,000 crore rupees has been given as loan waiver to the farmers of Maharashtra as a result of our struggle. So this can happen. Then, after these three struggles, about the Long March, in the next point I will say. The Long March started with 25,000 people from Nasik, 6th of March. It walked for 6 days and one night.